basically.
Listen to Banker.
Well, folks. Say, if we could all kind of take a moment here and listen for a minute, please. Well, as you all know, like I said before, and I'm going to repeat it again, I guess. But the reason why we are here, there is a reason why we are gathered here today. And that reason is that what is happening to our country and what has just happened really is something that really has hit us really, really hard. And we cannot just sit back and sit by and watch the murder that is actually taking place in our country. The violations are the reasons why we are here. The abuse of power is why we are here. The killings are why we are here. The abuses of our citizens are why we are here. So the reason why we are here today really is to address our grievances and to make sure that the international community and the Gambian people at large are aware of the fact that Gambians in general are not just gonna sit back and let these human rights abuses continue for any longer. And what we wanna demand here today is for the executions to stop right away. What we wanna demand here today is to make sure that we let Yahya Jammeh know that we want him to leave, and we want him to leave now. Basically, the 9 folks that were executed recently, and 38 more to be executed, is one of the main reasons why we also are here today. So let's not forget them in our prayers. We want to make sure that we highlight their plight and their families, the suffering that their families are going through, and to put their face to these names. Well, obviously, the Gambia government did tell us that these people are criminals, that they deserve to die. We are simply saying, well, yes, some of them may be criminals, who knows, maybe. But we are not too sure of that because the procedures were not followed. The law was not followed. Their rights were violated. What was supposed to happen did not happen. And that's why we are here today. We can all disagree on the death penalty. Some can be for it and some can be against it. That's a debate that we can always have. But that's not why we are here today. Why we are here today is to make sure that Gambians, each and every Gambian, the ones that were murdered and the ones that are about to be murdered, that those people, their rights have been looked after, and that their rights are protected, and to make sure that what happened to these 9 people never, ever, ever happened to any Gambian ever again. And we want to say to our Senegalese brothers, if they are listening, that we stand united with them, that what happened to their citizens are really, we find disgusting what Gambians do. We are ashamed of what took place in our country. And that we say to all the Senegalese people that we are very, very sorry for what happened to their citizens. That we will make sure that we address their plight, and we will make sure that no Senegalese is ever murdered in the Gambia like that. So on that note, we're gonna have several people come in so they can tell you the true story behind these stories. The people that were murdered, these 9 folks, their cases, we want to highlight their cases. Not to just talk about the execution, but to talk about what happened prior to the execution. And also to talk about how their executions took place. And to talk about how they got to the situation that they are in. And to show the violations that took place. We'll have Jello, who will first be the first speaker.
Yeah. Fellow Gambians and brothers and sisters, unfortunately, I'm talking on behalf of somebody who has already been killed. Daoud Abojang, Jebe Ba, and Lamine Dabo. These were our comrades in Gambia. They are our brothers and sisters. They are fathers, brothers, and uncles. Jebe Daoud Abojang was only sentenced by a magistrate court in the Gambia, not even had the chance to appeal his case. He was dragged at night, and then middle of the night taken to somewhere. He was executed at middle of the night. Lamine Dabo was almost like my age group. Lamine was sentenced to death, and he was committed, the death sentence was committed to life. Somebody who was in life sentence was dragged at night, middle of the night, not even had the due process of going to appeal. He was also dragged at night and taken to a firing squad. JB Ba is the same thing. Now, the problem we have in the Gambia is serious. Now, we need to focus our attention on the rest of the people who are about to be killed. Now, these people have already killed these ones. Now, that's nothing we can do unless and except we shout loud so that Senegalese and international community can come to our assistance. The problem we have the mercenary judges, we have even the lawyers in Gambia cannot even speak out because of fear of being prosecuted themselves. True. So we have a problem. We Gambians outside the Gambia have the better position to talk aloud and say what is happening in the Gambia is not right, it's just not right, and it's not right.
Thank you, Keba.
We talk about people that were actually murdered.
Yes, I do have a right.
So the ones I'm concentrating on is...
The ones I'm concentrating on is...
Lamin Jaju,
Lamin
Ayuba. Two of those names that I just said was... Two of those people was serving in the army with Jammeh. And they were sentenced for an attempted coup that he claims, an attempted coup. So they were sentenced for killing three people involved on an attempted coup. But as we all know, there's no proof to show that these people was killed. And with my researches, he accused these people for killing people, but he don't show who they killed and how they did it. So my concern is, if we don't show the evidence outright, you cannot charge somebody, let alone to lock them up, let alone to death. Even in America, they get it wrong on the death penalty, let alone Gambia.
Thank you.
We don't need a death penalty. So what I'm saying right now is, we need to stay away from this death penalty till further notice. It's up to Gambia to debate what we do about it. Capital punishment is not what we need in Gambia.
Thank
so
you.
To everybody out here, it's a start. It's a start. We need to go ahead and start speaking. Because the people in Gambia cannot speak because we know what the reason. And we cannot be sitting here and being scared what's going to happen to your mom or what's going to happen to your grandma back home. Because sooner or later, something is going to happen to your family and you're going to want somebody to speak for you. And no one is going to speak for you because we have the same attitude. Don't say nothing because they're going to come after you.
Right.
So that's all I have to say.
Thank you. Stop this killing.
These three were killed and there's no due process. There's no lengthy trial. Tabata Sambu, I will elaborate on her because she's not Gambian nationality. So we get more information from her family from Senegal. The others, I can really talk about them few because their family are scared to say what they were sentenced for. What the government have put for Tabata Sambu, that she did kill her husband. Yes, she did, but it's not like she intentionally killed her husband. She did not premeditated the killing. Mm-hmm. This is, she was...
That's right!
She did not plan it to kill her husband. She was in an abusive marriage with her husband. The day her husband come and tell her, I married a second wife, there was an argument on there, then they started on it while she was cooking, she poured and had oil on her husband, which caused his death. So she didn't have the right counsel, she didn't have a proper counsel for trial to help her with her case. So since she was arrested, she was sentenced right away for life. They don't even let their family in the courtroom. These people were taken to a secret place where she was abused by Jammeh's troop. Mr. Jammeh ordered his troop to repeatedly rape her. She was really abused before she was even executed. And this is very sad, and we need to stop this.
Yes. Thank you.
We need due process. We need freedom of speech, and we have the right to trial.
Thank you.
We have the right to trial and pick jury.
Get closer to the people. Okay, that's good now.
Yeah, that's good. First of all, I want to thank everybody for coming here today. And just a night before this execution happened, I had the opportunity to review the whole constitution of the Gambia.
What's your opinion?
Yeah, I wanted to tax the lawmakers. I wanted to tax every Gambian that understood the Gambian law that we also felt in our responsibility. But again, we still have an opportunity to set things right. Already 9 people are executed, and it is our responsibility to prevent the execution of the others. Now, the execution that happened in Gambia did not follow all the legal requirements of the Gambian constitution. First and foremost, judges sentenced people to death, and in the first place, that was not supposed to happen in the Gambia. Because it went for 15 years, and then the death sentence was not reviewed by the National Assembly in the Gambia to decide if we have to keep on with the death sentence or if we have to do away with it in totality. Most importantly, it was the duty of the president to make sure that he had a consultation with the Minister of Justice before he issued a death warrant. But this didn't take place, because I have an understanding that what happened on Thursday, what did not happen on Thursday, how did the same exact incident happen on a Sunday night?
That's right. All right. That's a good point.
So, as a matter of fact, it simply implies that the Minister of Justice was not aware of the execution, because the Minister of Justice they issued a press release to say that executions never happened. Even after it happened, it was not the responsibility of the Ministry of Interior. The Constitution mandates that it was the Justice Department and the President's Office that should issue a public notice to say that the executions occurred. First and foremost, the president was supposed, in the death warrant, the president was supposed to notify the families of the victims. Mm-hmm. Right. The president was supposed to give us a public notice.
That's right.
Supposed to tell us who, when, where, and how these people
are going to
be executed.
That's right.
The president was supposed to tell us how these people are supposed
to be buried.
None of this ever happened.
Thank you.
So we will know that the Constitution was not completely followed.
I'm going to say this real quick. I'm sorry, guys. I'm going to have to say this. We need to stop calling this an execution based on what he said.
It's murder.
Yeah. Okay,
murder.
This is mass murder.
Right.
What's our meaning? We need to start using the right words, guys.
Okay, I'm sorry.
So, before anything should have continued, I believe the president should have followed the Constitution. But in a country like the Gambia, when somebody is in authority of power like Yahya Jammeh, they feel that they can simply give an order.
That's
and
right.
And it's going to happen.
Thank you.
This is our country. It is our responsibility to stand up for our nation. We have a responsibility. It is time to move up from commitment to action.
Thank you.
We don't want to hear that we are going to do this, we are going to do
it.
It's about time to jump into action.
That's
action
right.
is what is most needed. This is the 21st century,
Thank
brother.
You.
And we have to do something about that.
Yeah. Amen.
I challenge all my fellow young people, whether you studied abroad or you in the Gambia. I did have a consultation with a lot of young people, and then we're trying to do our research on the root causes of crimes in the Gambia.
Thank you.
Execution or death penalty did not stop crimes in any country.
Right on.
Even after the execution of people in Gambia, I will just tell you, somebody robbed the First International Bank branch office in Serekunda and stole $2 million.
Yeah, wow, there you go.
And that after the execution. Mm-hmm. So what we'll tell you, because of economic hardship, because of the conditions of Gambian people, because of the influx of immigrants in the Gambian society, things like this are about to happen and they're going to continue.
Correct.
So what we have to do is to look at the root causes of these issues and try to make sure that government is responsible for creating policies to address these root causes.
Amen.
But if you cannot feed your family, you cannot feed your children, what
Amen.
Will you do? You will turn into crime.
That's
so
right.
It is our responsibility to tax the government and tax ourselves to do something about it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ambassador yourself, Mr. Seka, he is an elderly in our community, and he will have something to say.
Okay, assalamu alaikum. Li may wax na deguma anglais français la digawona legui li ma len di yeugal moy li ñun ñep ñoko bok sama ñetti sété nga gambia
deglu len fi deglu
len nga gambia sama ñetti sété nga gambia ko xamadi chama serikunda gañu la moy sama tante fofu mari chambu ndaw turondom mi ngi gañu stockholm in 1987 1981 mamu ñu bok ndey bay since 1963 bi may jangale école vacation bu ma dem buma am fofu la ko done passé ñun ñepp ño bokk ndey bay len dal la len di yeugal buna am dara lu ñuy ragal buna am dara lu ñuy tit gis ngeen xada fi gis ngeen Saddam Hussein
ñoo
nañu ñom legi
ko deug